I'm the pumpkin.
I'm Shady.
And this is Seven Bedroom Suite video edition. We've just come back from a special Valentine's Day outing to see This Means War, or as we refer to it, Pine and Hardy. Because the only thing that you need to know about this movie is that Tom Hardy and Chris Pine are in it.
Spend a lot of time making eyes at each other.
Yeah, they're best friends, and they say I love you to each other.
A lot.
Over and over again.
It's so cute.
And there's, like, you know, touching, and it's adorable.
Dude, I love you.
No, I love you.
Aw, that's so cool. I'll see you later.
Okay, bye. Oh, wait.
What is it?
I just wanted to remind you that I love you.
Oh, I'd forgotten, but that's awesome. Just, I love you too, man. Oh. All right, see ya. Wait.
And basically, it's just a romance.
It's a love fest.
It's a love. Yeah, I mean, I guess there's a girl in it. Right?
Somewhere.
I mean, right? I think so.
She was all right.
She was cool, I guess.
Can't remember what she looked like.
But the only important thing is the bond. The bond between friends who are really hot.
So hot.
Yeah. Okay, so plot. For anybody who doesn't. Anybody who hasn't seen the trailer. Okay, so you have Pine and Hardy, and they have really dorky names for some reason. Tuck and JFK.
Because you're charming.
Did we ever learn what JFK stood for?
FDR.
Oh, FDR.
Chris Pine plays a guy named FDR, and Tom Hardy is a man named Tuck. FDR stands for Franklin. Like,
So is he actually Franklin Delano? Like, is that actually FDR?
FDR.
FDR, not JFK. And Tuck are international spies. Was it actually CIA?
Well, they said that. It looked more like Men in Black to me.
Yeah. The Chris Pine character is... Oh.
I lost my earring back.
Okay. I'll explain. The Chris Pine character is kind of like the playboy. And the Tom Hardy character is... He's a dad and a divorcee. And he's kind of more shy and responsible and wants something more serious.
You know. Unicorn.
Yeah, he's a unicorn.
And like a hot super spy who just wants a family.
Hot British tattooed unicorn.
I took my lady out on a really great date. And I was super sensitive and attentive. You know, excuse me. And you find my date with this woman funny. Anyway, we went out, had a marvelous time. Took her to do the trapeze, and of course. I can do trapeze because I'm an incredible super spy. And
what type did you get any?
That's so coarse. All right. She's a lady. I'm a gentleman. A foxy gentleman. With incredible eyes. And washboard abs. That's beside the point. We did happen to, you know, we shared a kiss. All he wants is to find the one. He
just wants to be held.
And just don't.
So let's just talk about Chris Pine for a second. Chris Pine. Because he's kind of got that, like... And then there's... Doesn't even matter that he's a total horn dog because he's beautiful and he's Chris Pine and he has impossible eyes.
And of course he has redeeming qualities because...
Yeah, I mean, he's obviously like the dog with the heart of gold. It's what you know, doesn't exist. But we get to see it over and over again.
Yeah. Thanks for that.
So we have these two and they sort of stumble into the relationships with the same woman who is Reese Witherspoon, a.k.a. the girl we hate. But no, we don't actually really hate her because
she's great.
She's awesome. Yeah. Like, I actually really liked her, and I didn't expect to, because a lot of times there's not a lot of effort put into developing
the love. She didn't just become that bitch who doesn't deserve either one.
Yeah, you kind of, instead of it being, because I knew that this movie was made for women, like, because the minute you see it, and you see that these men are in it, you're just like, I'm going to see it.
Clearly.
I don't even care. But, so I assumed there wouldn't be any effort put into making the Reese Witherspoon character likable. Because I kind of thought her purpose would be just, like, the girl that you're jealous of, and you don't really care what happens to her, or whether she's happy or not. But I wanted her to be happy.
Yeah.
I was actually invested.
It's probably because of the gentleman's agreement.
Yeah. They actually use the phrase, gentleman's agreement.
Robin, will you do the honors?
A gentleman's agreement!
Huzzah!
When they find out pretty soon that they're both dating her, And she hasn't told either one that she's dating somebody else, but they figure it out. And so they say, like, okay, we're going to make a gentleman's agreement. It's basically to stay out of each other's way and that neither one is going to sleep with her.
Yeah. And then also, may the man who's best for her win.
Right. For her. For her. They just want her to be happy.
Right.
So then, like, you know, hijinks ensue and all the funny stuff from the trailer, like the tranquilizer dart.
Yeah. Way funnier than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, it was the way, it was Chris Pine, it was the way he played it. He does passing out really well. I noticed that in Star Trek, he's really good at being beat up and strung out. It's pretty awesome. Our initial reactions were...
incredible.
We loved it, and it was ridiculous how much we loved it.
Yeah. Laughing pretty much the whole time.
Yeah, well, I actually happened to see that it was written by... One of the people who wrote it was the person who wrote Role Models, which I thought was a brilliant movie. So it was actually had a good script for the most part. There were two times in the movie that I found myself thinking, like, really Hollywood? And it was, like, there was one crotch shot and one, like, oh, funny out of control dog thing.
Let's clarify. By crotch shot, she means a shot at the crotch.
Oh, I don't mean, like, a shot of a crotch. Yeah, sorry. Yeah. Like, you know... Shot to the balls, which, to be fair, is always funny, but sometimes I feel like it's an overmind concept for humor.
Wait for the Three Stooges movie.
Yeah, well, wait, there's a Three Stooges movie?
Oh, yeah.
And while those weren't, like, awful in themselves, I was just like, you're more than this movie. You could have done better. You didn't have
better.
You didn't have to resort to these clichés, like...
Don't be so cheap.
Because so much of it was just above the cliché and above the comic misunderstanding, and I felt like... You know, there was actual effort put into it, which was great, because it's a February movie with hot guys. Like, who knew there would be effort involved?
They didn't really need to try that hard.
They didn't.
Who would have been satisfied with pretty much anything? Like, if you just give me Chris Pine and Tom Hardy on the same screen saying I love you to each other?
I know.
We're good.
They were
with
so
a couple
cute.
Of jokes, fine. But it seemed like they actually tried.
Yeah, and it was just like, ugh. And they were like, oh, they were each other's family, and it was...
He's his only friend. I thought Uncle Frank was your only friend.
Work. I don't even know how much more there is to say, except it's amazing and everyone should see it everywhere.
Oh!
What?
It's actually not related to the movie, but for those of you who actually read the blog, this is our new apartment!
Oh yeah, we live together now! This is my room.
You can't really see much of it. There's a lab.
We have a third room that, in the old days, I suppose, used to be a billiards room.
Billiards room.
Now
yes.
It's now
billions.
Now it's a storage room, but it's bigger than the two of our rooms combined.
It's the size of most folks' apartments.
And there's windows, and it's amazing, and it's so sad how it's basically full of trash now. I mean, once it was full of stored furniture, but over time,
it's become trash.
It's all so.
There's a fainting chaise that is totally demolished. Like, I don't even know why it's still up there.
There's like all this like there's bookshelves with backs falling off of them, but we're gonna clean it up.
We're gonna hold AA meetings there.
Yeah,
anyone wants to come to the 7-bedroom suite Alcoholics Anonymous meeting.
That too, and it's gonna be much more. Epic than any other AA meeting you've ever been to.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm not going to tell you how. You'll just have to come and find out for yourself what that means.
That's not a euphemism, by the way.
It is a euphemism. So anyway, back to Pine and Hardy.
Right.
We wholeheartedly recommend that movie, and just, I don't know, don't be fooled by the fact that it seems like a really formulaic premise, and that it comes out in February, like, it's so much better than you think it's going to be. And if you already think it's going to be awesome, then it's even more awesome than that.
But don't allow us to psych you out by, you know, I don't know, grain of salt or whatever.
Yeah, I mean, we're
don't go there like, they said it was going to be the best movie ever! I want my money! None of that.
I guess we're not the last word, but I don't know. I feel like where Chris Pine is concerned, I kind of am the last word. Or I'd like to be. Yeah.
His eyes, you guys.
They're not real. So happy Valentine's Day, everyone. And don't be one of these people who thinks that you can't celebrate if you don't have a boyfriend, because neither do we. And we're just, you know, we're here to celebrate our love for each other and for Chris Pine and Tom Hardy.
It's very real love.
So, it's the realest love there is. And between FDR and Tuck, who are a love that will last a lifetime. You can tell. All right. Good night. I'm Pumpkin.
I'm Shady.
And love you.
I'm not gonna go.
I love you.
You suck at this.
Sorry, I don't understand what's going on.